Ahh Antonio Brown, how I don't miss thee. At this point, and I'm sure I'm not alone with fellow Pittsburgh Steelers fans, I just want to move on from Brown. I'm appreciative of his 9 seasons in the black and gold, but realize it is time to move on. Sure, I didn't like how he forced his way out of town, but at the same time, after watching his newfound love affair with Derek Carr, I'm over it. Time to move on. The Steelers seemingly have, and this was evident from Kevin Colbert and Mike Tomlin's comments at the NFL owners' meetings in Phoenix, but for some reason Antonio Brown just can't seem to let go. Remorse over the way he left. Having second thoughts? No one knows, but at every turn you see Brown saying, or posting, something which is a direct response to something that was said, or done, by a member of the Steelers organization. As Brown executed his plan to get out of Pittsburgh, he kick-started the Bash Ben Roethlisberger fan club. Former players, along with both Brown and Le'Veon Bell, cited how Roethlisberger wasn't a good teammate, and a subpar leader. Eventually Juju Smith-Schuster, among others, stood up for their quarterback. I was so blessed to enter the league and play with a Hall of Fame QB as a 20-year-old. Ben has taught me so much, he's a true leader and I can't wait to rock with my guy this season. Picked at twitter.com/tay8@askjujusmithschuster at Team Juju, March 26, 2019. For fans who felt Roethlisberger was being treated unfairly, this was a breath of fresh air. But don't worry, Brown had to chime in with a not-so-subtle tweet directed at Smith-Schuster and others who came to Roethlisberger's side. Do not listen to any NFL player who haven't got paid yet. They will do and say anything to make sure they're going to get paid, even if it's compromising integrity or anything. Sad but true. Antonio Brown, at @ab84, March 26, 2019. The erratic behavior continues with Brown, this long after the trade between the Oakland Raiders and Steelers had been finalized, when he recorded a conversation he had with his agent, Drew Rosenhaus, regarding teams who were interested in trading for him. Take a listen for yourself, and ask yourself who records these type of conversations. Brown's behaviors reek of either indecision or insecurity, and to show everyone how great he is, the deal he received was Brown posted his current pay structure on all of his social media platforms. I'd go on, but this is an ongoing trend from Brown since the day he signed on the dotted line in Oakland. Yes, it is the off-season, and Brown likely has a lot of time on his hands to sit and see what is being said, done on social media, but at what point do you just move on? At what point do you focus solely on your new gig which gifted you so much money? At what point do you not concern yourself with what Juju, James Conner or Ryan Shazier thinking about Ben Roethlisberger, or anything else Steelers-related? Speaking for myself, I look forward to the day when Brown simply focuses on the Raiders and nothing more. However, I am also not foolish enough to foresee this happening anytime soon. Until, or should I say if, that ever happens, Brown will continue to inject himself into the Steelers conversation because that is what he wants.